All right, just want to give a disclaimer ahead of time. It is 15 degrees in Columbus. I don't know what the sound is going to sound like because I have my furnace on. I'm not turning it off. I'm not about to freeze to record this. What is up, YouTube world? It's your boy Jerome Knows Nothing. And I know absolutely nothing. Don't know why you tuned in other than be entertained, but I don't know nothing. But we gonna learn, right? That's the whole point of the whole YouTube setup that I've got here. As I learn, you learn, we learn, big learning family. So remember to like, share, subscribe. That's what you're supposed to do on YouTube, especially if you want more of this type of content. You heard? But off of the jokes, off of the silliness, let's talk about something serious here today. How do we do this? So Arrogant's been a company for about 3 years. It'll be 4 years next month. I just want y'all to know it's not easy. Please don't get into streetwear fashion thinking that it's going to be easy money, because it's not enough to do anything with at the beginning stages at all. Probably not even in the later stages, honestly. Most of it is the way that I advertise. Most of it is I'm not outside, but neither here or there, it's not easy. So please don't try to get into this thinking that it's just peaches and cream and money's gonna come out of nowhere. It's hard work. It is more hard work than anybody thinks when they just jumping into it. They just think it's a couple of shirts and everybody's gonna buy. No, not at all. I mean, even with my stuff, I don't believe that I have trash stuff. I will wear my stuff if I seen it in a store somewhere. I love the quality of the product. It feels soft. I like the print and the artwork. But that doesn't mean that everybody else loves it the same way. And it's a lot of expenses that are involved with it. I mean, t-shirts are not cheap. Printing's not cheap. Even if you're printing in-house, I mean, you've got to buy equipment. It's just not cheap at all. I mean, right now, Arrogant is not being funded by my 9-to-5 job. It's being funded by other hobbies, because I don't want to use my money that are used for other expenses for a streetwear startup brand. This is more of like a dream project, a passion project. It's not anything that I really want to cause my house to go under or cut out my shoe buying, because I have, I guess, a passion for the start of streetwear. Right now it's being funded by when I do photography on the side. If I get booked for weddings, if I get booked for portraits, I use that money for funding my brand right now. And sometimes it ends up being where it is the perfect amount, and then sometimes I look up and it's like, I didn't really make enough to do what I really want to do with my brand. It's an expensive thing to do. And then you got to think about this. I mean, there's so many people today that just want to do streetwear because they're young, they're hip, and fashion is a thing to do when you're young and hip, I guess. I don't really know the real answer why everybody wants to get into this field. I get contacted every day still about how do I get this done or how do I get that done. And I've gotten to the point now, I kind of ignore some phone calls. I will tell some people what to do, but a lot of times when I do have real conversations, I will tell them, don't get into this. Use your money to get into something else. And not to just tell them don't do it, but if their heart's really in it, they're gonna do it anyway. But I want them to know the real. Just this month alone, I mean, we're only a couple of weeks into the month with buying equipment, because I wanna cut out the middleman. I mean, that's an expense that isn't accounted for in our regular household budget. I have a wife, I have a child, we live in a house, we have two cars, we have groceries and other needs like that, like most adults do. And when you then add in, all right, I have this idea of a clothing line, which you're looking at numbers that you're possibly not gonna start seeing a return in reality for the first 7 years, unless you just happen to get popping in your first couple of years. But you don't wanna start taking away from your car, your house, because you have a passion for this. The reality is, it's a field that's oversaturated with everybody that's talented, everybody who's offering, I guess, in a sense, the same thing as the next man. I mean, there's already, in my city alone, 10 brands that I know off hand that we're in the same lane. We're doing astrophysics like artwork on our streetwear, and that makes it tough because how do I stand out from them aside from actually having a conversation and saying, this is my brand, this is what I stand for, and here's a brochure or here's my website or anything like that. It ends up being so much more work than what you think you're bargaining for. I would not get in this field unless you absolutely want it. You have to absolutely want it. You have to not mind losing sleep. You have to want to go shake hands and meet people and network. And some people aren't meant for that. I've seen a lot of streetwear brands recently die off because they thought that it would be easier work. And it's not. It's not easy work at all. So I'm gonna leave you with this. This streetwear thing is not easy. But nothing in life worth having is easy. So if this is what you want, just know that it is a very, very rough road. Maybe one day I'll get in front of this camera and I'll show an expense report from my first few years of the brand so you can see everything that went outgoing and then you can see what actually came in. Because I know a lot of people think that this is just an easy flip to get money, and it's not. Please don't look at this that way. If you want to have fun, like that's what I do with the brand, I have fun. I enjoy doing this. Then do it for that. Do it because you have the passion for having fun. I'm artistic and I do most of the artwork on the product. So if you're gonna do that, then yeah, it's expression. I mean, you want to express yourself, do that. But if you're looking for a quick flip, I honestly don't suggest it. That's all I got today, YouTube. Like, share, subscribe. Till next time.